Hi guys, I hope all of you are able to hear me.
Yes, sir, good morning. Chetan here.
Good morning, Chetan. I'm just waiting for the others to join. Let's give another 5 minutes and then we will get started.
Sure.
Today's program. Any of you don't know me who have actually joined here, if you don't know me, you can just actually raise your hand or just put a message in chat box. So I'll just briefly introduce you. Otherwise, I'll get started. So all of you know me? Great. Okay, fantastic. So since all of you know me, let me directly dive into today's topic. Today's topic will be mainly on the, okay. So Gopal is asking me that he wants to know. Okay, I'll just give a quick 2 minutes introduction about myself. My name is Sriharsha. I'm a digital marketing coach and a consultant. I have been running the agency from the last 20 years. I have been serving more than 200 clients in more than 8 countries. So I've been doing digital marketing from 15 years where people in India had no idea about digital marketing. It only from the last few years, people have a lot of idea about digital marketing. So I have worked extensively on almost every area of digital marketing. So I'll be talking to you about different ways in which you can make money online. That is the series which I'm actually created, which has started from yesterday. So it is recorded. So I'll be sharing you the recording also, that will be helpful for you. So I think this is good enough to get started. Okay, great. So if any of you have anything else in mind, if you have any specific thing in mind, you can please tell me. You can actually put this in the chat box right below, or you can always actually unmute yourself and tell and then actually mute yourself back. So that is another thing which is possible. So if you have anything specific, you can please ask me before I get started. Nathaniel, I think you are trying to talk something. I'm not able to clearly hear you. Anything you want to say, or I can get started? No, I think background noise. Okay, I'll just mute him. Okay, so today I will be mainly talking to you about freelancing. So how you can actually, this is something which any of you can do, and all of you have some basic talent which you can utilize here, and you can start generating revenue for yourself. So the whole agenda will be about how you can actually build your freelancing profile, and how you can take the advantage of the different platforms which are available, some of the platforms which I extensively use. So I'll actually share this with you. So there are two ways in which you can make money out of this. Number one, you can outsource work at damn cheap rates. You will get a fantastic freelancers available at a very, very cheap rates, and you can get the work done. That is one thing. Second thing is you can probably take up any of the freelancing job which you are actually accustomed, which you can personally do, and you can also make revenue out of this. So I'll actually share with you two powerful sites. Okay, let me first share the screen with you. I'll share with you two different websites which I'll be talking to you extensively today. The first one is Freelancer, and the other one is called Fiverr. Now, both of them work a little different. And both of them are extremely powerful. There's a lot of traffic. So when we talk about traffic, see what happens is online, when you start any any product, service, or anything. I've been telling you that you don't really need a website. Website is not really required. You can get started even without having a website. So the beauty of this is this. You have to go to a place like a marketplace. Like yesterday I was talking to you about Amazon, Flipkart, and all. No? Similar to that, for freelancers, these are the marketplaces. This is another thing is called Upwork. Upwork is also very popular. I have not extensively used Upwork, but Upwork is definitely a place where you can go ahead and seek a lot of work. There are other things like Elance and all, but I have been using extensively Freelancer and Fiverr, and I have found this extensively powerful. What I've seen is in Upwork, the advantage is the kind of money you can make in Upwork is pretty high compared to what you can make in Freelancer. So if you are a freelancer, you want to make money as a freelancer, the best place could be to be in place like Upwork, where you can take the orders. You can take the orders here. I'll tell you one another concept which actually works very well with most of the places. Now, this is called as we call this as arbitrage. Arbitrage is something like you buy from one place. You can also call it as a trade. So what all the traders do, they buy from one place, they sell in another place. So it is not only for product, you can also do for service. So I have been doing this extensively and you can also do this. I'll actually show you what actually can be done. Suppose you don't know any of the things. Suppose you are not actually very good in any of the things. It doesn't matter. You just have to do. See, what happens is you need to know where you can actually get this done at a cheaper rate. And you should know where you can sell it at a higher rate. That's a very simple thing. That's how actually any market, whether it is a stock market, vegetable market, or any sort of market, everywhere, this is how actually it works. Now, Upwork is a place where you get all premium customers, where the kind of money actually people are ready to pay is quite high. It all depends on the reviews you build. Please understand, on online, what happens is everything is dependent on your reviews. So that is the reason why I actually told you that whatever I'm doing this free. I don't expect any money from all of you, but what I expect is at least a video from you saying if you have actually got benefited with the knowledge which I have been sharing with you, just actually make a short video. It could be for 30 seconds, 1 minute, whatever it is. It really helps me because that builds my personal review online. That is how actually people start getting connected. That's where people start trusting the other guy. So in Upwork, is a place where you can get at very, very high cost. In fact, Fiverr was one another place where you could get at very cheaper rates. But nowadays, actually, this has become quite expensive. There are places where you, even in Fiverr, you can actually get cheaper. You have to dig a little deeper, which I will share with you. And Freelancer is definitely another place where you can do this. So let me actually get first dived into Fiverr and show you. Because Fiverr and Freelancer both work a little different. Now, what happens in Fiverr is you are telling about a particular product. Like I have a particular product or service. I have been actually talking about that particular product or service. Now, this is actually my partner, Karthik. So this is, we had created in his name the account. Let's actually go to the actual Fiverr thing. Okay, one second. Okay, so if you see here, mm-hmm. Okay. If you look at this, what is happening here is you can find a lot of categories in which you can find freelancers. Now, how a Fiverr works is you need to tell people what are you good at. Now, when it started, the main thing what it was talking to you is the reason why the name Fiverr is there is because it started the services with just $5. So you could do anything starting from $5. So there were fantastic deals which were available. Now also you have to dig deeper. You will definitely find a lot of good deals. So if you see here on digital marketing, which I was actually working on. So there are a lot of things which are there. Social media marketing is there. SEO is there. Marketing strategy is there. Let me actually just show you one of them. So what happens is you can tell people what exactly is the service you will be optimizing. What is the service you will be providing? So you can talk about anything which you are actually doing. And if you look at this, the pricing varies from person to person. So the easiest thing is what you can do is you can do one thing is put a budget. Budget could be maybe let me put this as $5 is the bare minimum thing which they start with. So I'll just put as 500 rupees to 2000 rupees. Let me actually see what is available in this budget. So you can see even at that budget, there are a lot of people who are offering a lot of things. Because see, when people get started, they actually want to build that review and they are ready to do at a good rate. Now here, what you need to do is just try to select either don't get into the new seller because you have no credibility with them. If there is a level two seller, definitely there is a lot of credibility with this person. Level one is good enough. You can also see level one. But level two is more preferred. So what I actually was doing is I used to find out what are they doing. So this is my own field. So I used to do this work. So that is not a problem. But even for other things, like I was actually selling something on YouTube. YouTube, we were actually having a different thing like we could actually increase the views of the videos and all. We were actually doing, somebody else was doing. What I was doing is I was just taking that. So he was giving me 1 million views or something. So what I used to do is I used to split that to multiple people. So I used to give at a different rate. Now that actually is not working. So it's not being done. But I'm just trying to tell you, you have to see how, you have to start thinking how you can take advantage of this. See, think about this. There are people who are actually doing at different prices. So you can see this is the service somebody is offering. Now, one of the thing is you can actually look at what service they are offering. Now you have reviews in place, so you know how good they are. You also know by when they are going to deliver. You also have a clear idea about what are they going to deliver. So the easiest thing what you could do is you want to sell this, you can sell this on your own particular personal website. You can take all the description, whatever they have given about this, what are they going to do? So they have actually given an in-detail description about what they are able to do and when they are able to do. So the simplest thing what I actually do is I take a little time understanding what are the different kinds of things people are doing. I also try to see something which is being done by at least few more people. It's not only one person. So it could be multiple people. It could be like the easiest thing you can actually look here is a lot of options available, especially in the video and animation. There are a lot of actually people who do this. Okay, one second. I think okay. Singers and vocalists. So a lot of actually singers are there. A lot of voice tuning music. Okay, voiceover. This is the easiest thing, actually. Any of us actually can give a voiceover. It doesn't take much time. So if you look at this, this is one thing. You can actually go ahead and buy somebody. See, top rated seller, definitely they are doing fantastic work. Level two sellers are doing fantastic work. There's no doubt on that. So what you could do is you try to see who is actually going to give you at a cheaper rates and good deals. So you can also select people if you want a voiceover in probably in Hindi. So you can actually look at that also. There will be people, how many, see Bengali 95 people are there. Now Punjabi 129 people. So Marathi 51, Thai, Persian, Tamil, Kannada 22 people are there, Tamil 47 people. Where is Hindi, Hebrew? How come Hindi? I'm not able to see. Okay, Hindi is there. 610 people are there in Hindi. So you can see that you can actually get whatever you want to do. You want to actually do with a local person, you can also do that. So what happens is you will get that local accent also. So you want these are one of the easiest things to do. See, it could be anything you want to do here. What you can do is you can actually take the best services from here and probably you can advertise on your own personal website or on your blog or any other places. That is another thing which you can do. So that is one thing. And what I actually personally do is I try to look at what is something which is very common people are doing and which has a lot of demand. Especially you can look at this graphic designs. It could be a logo design, for example. So you can actually sell this as a service. You can actually get it done at a cheaper rate here. And you can actually, you can sell it at a much higher rate here. So suppose I want only in the range of 500 to 1000, I want to do. I'll actually find a lot of people here. I will actually, I want only level two sellers. So I'll just select only level two sellers. There are around 4,000 people here available. So I can also take the top rated sellers. There is a top rated seller who is doing at these rates. It's amazing. So what you can do is you can go to them and you can just click on any of the any of their description. You will also find a lot of work which they have done. So you also get samples. So this is something which anybody will ask you about the samples. You can see a lot of samples which are there, which the beauty of Fiverr is they actually share a lot of samples. Whenever you are delivering anything, you can actually share that particular thing as a sample. So if you see here, this is a work. I think it is taking time to get loaded. So here the work has been done and the review of the person is also actually mentioned here. So I think for these things, it is taking time to get loaded. Okay, so you can see here. This is the work done. And for that, the review which is given by the customer is also getting there. So what you can do is you can just actually take a couple of these samples and these samples will help you in actually sharing with, you can use this for, you can speak with them. You have an option with them. You want to talk with them. There is, if you just go below, they will be giving you an option for, talking to these people, you can talk to the guy. See here, there's something called contact me. You can just contact them and tell that I want to sell your services. I want to use your samples or you can ask them for samples. They will be eager to give you. So what happens is that you can go ahead and sell to somebody else. So you can explore this Fiverr. You will get a fair idea about what all different options are available and you can go ahead and sell. So you get at a cheaper rate and you can sell at a much higher rate. So this is one place where here what happens is everything has to be told in advance. Like, for example, I am doing X service, I can tell in advance. Now, there's another thing, like in this guy, you want some customized thing to be done. You can also speak to the person. You can tell, I don't want logo, but I see your work is good. Can you do a banner for me? Can you do XYZ, something else for me? You can always tell to the person, and that is possible, and they can give you a custom quotes. So it works like anything. So this is, Fiverr is good, both from the point of view of actually getting the orders as well as actually selling the orders, because there's a lot of traffic which is coming in Fiverr. Is there any question related to Fiverr before I actually talk to you about Freelancer? If there is any question, I would like to address at this point of time.
Hey, hi, Harsha. I have a question, please.
Yeah, tell me.
Harsha, can we filter this service provider by location? Let us say I want to identify someone within my locality. Is it possible?
Yeah, that is possible here. I was just showing you. I'm just actually putting a random thing, a landing page. So in service options, I think either in the service options or not here. In the seller details, it is there. Seller details, you can see here. You want somebody to speak.
Yeah, I'm from Bangalore, and let us say I want to look for someone who stays close.
See, so seller in this place. So you want somebody from India, you can select that.
India is fine. See, I'm saying within my locality, let us say South Bangalore.
I don't think so much is possible. Is possible.
Thanks. Yeah.
Okay. Anybody else has any other question before I talk to you about other things?
How do you create these banners here, Harsha? Because we already see some banners out there when you advertise. Let us say saying, you know, persuasive landing page, copywriting, high converting landing page. So these are definitely the banners which are created. Now, these we need to create up, and we can.
Hire any of these people and actually get it done. See, if you have to do it, I will do one more session, which is only going to be there about this, about the graphic designs and all. I'll share with you. That will be another topic, not today. But it's very easy. You can do it. There are a lot of things which are possible.
Yeah, Harsha, one suggestion. Sorry to interrupt. See, you have nicely put the dates also in your invite. Starting 2nd, 3rd, 4th, like that. I think it would also help. You can just indicate, you know, what topic you are covering, so that, you know, people who are interested will definitely join us. Because otherwise, I wouldn't know what are you going to cover tomorrow, for example.
Correct. I'll actually make that. Probably I'll do that. So let's talk relevant to this particular topic. Is there any question? Then I will address that.
Okay.
Is there any question which is relevant to the topic which I have discussed right now?
Yes, sir. Can we create both buyer as well as seller profile on this Fiverr?
Yes. Hello? Yes, you can do both.
Hello.
Yes, you can do both.
Action, sir. Bhaskar.
Yeah, tell me, Bhaskar.
Just now you showed that voice over, and you clicked one customer, expert in that. And how do we link it to our website? Can you just show me on the screen?
I didn't understand. Can you please repeat the question?
We are selling their product also, no?
No, you want to sell their product. The easiest thing what you can do is ask them to get some samples. Suppose you have this guy, you want to actually link up with this guy. You ask him to give some samples, take those samples, put it on your website, and tell, you don't have to showcase this guy. You can actually tell that I am actually doing the voiceover. Because it's the same thing which any trader will do. You go to, the local Kirana shop guy is going to go to Chickpit and get all the materials, and then he's going to sell. It's the same thing. Anywhere, this is what happens. So you'll never know where actually is the source from. You don't have to know. So you can actually, there are a lot of sites which are built where you can actually, you just have to showcase different talents. You need to have a male talent, you need to have a female talent, you need to have a US accent, UK accent, Indian accents. You could have different kind of accent if you are focused only on the voiceover thing. So you can have a website which actually only caters to voiceover. So that is possible. And you can get some of the best talents available. See, people are not worried about who is actually doing as long as they're doing a great job. So here you will get, you will find the sample, you can see for yourself. So you have reviews in front of you. So you will actually know, is this the right guy for hiring this? So you can always take orders upfront. And then actually, after that, you can always give the orders to them. You know, see the date of delivery. For example, this guy is doing 2 days delivery. I can actually put as 5 days delivery. I don't have to. I have that buffer time. Because today I get the order, probably I will outsource it the next day. Or I can actually hire somebody who will actually do only this work. So I can actually select all these people who I want to do. This is what I actually personally do. I select a couple of people
whom I am
interested to outsource the work. So once actually I'm ready, I have an Excel sheet which is made. So I actually just put all the orders to different people. And the other person is actually going to outsource the orders. So we have actually made everything very much systematic in that particular thing. Gopal is, Bhaskar, what is the, where are you not getting the thing? If you can ask
for me, it is very simple. See, what is this voiceover? What is this? What are the service they are doing? I really don't know. And why we should use also, I don't know. But we want to make freelancer. We want to, as a freelancer, what we can do? You just give one example. Because we don't know what is voiceover.
Okay.
Voiceover is also, we don't know.
Okay.
No. So many products are there on the website. So many products are there. Suppose we want to take one and sell their products. Is it okay?
Okay. Bhaskar, for you, voiceover is just giving out the voice in a simple
way. I don't want their product explanation also. Just we want to sell their products. What we have to do? That's all my question.
Okay. What you have to do means, Bhaskar, based on one example,
from starting to end, where we have to put it in our website so that sale is happened. Or you can show me how the sale is happened in your website also.
Okay, what I actually personally did is, I personally do here is, I put this on Fiverr itself. Okay, let me show you in...
That is important.
Okay, let me get into Fiverr itself. Let me actually get into the earnings.
Is it required to register ourselves in Fiverr?
Yes, you need to register in Fiverr.
Okay, once we register, we can do the transactions.
Yes.
Okay.
So if you see here, this is one of the account where I have actually done close to around $8,000. There are other accounts where I think I have done some $12,000 and all. So what actually happens here is, I actually have my own, here what they say is, for everything which we are putting here on the main site, whatever you are seeing, okay, where is that? So every service, whatever we are trying to give here, that is called as one gig here. So you need to add as many gigs as possible. Now, gigs is nothing but it is a simply you are actually trying to explain people what exactly you are trying to do here. Okay, I need to go to buying one.
So Harsha, can I ask you one question related to this?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, so switch to selling, switch to buying you're doing. So in there itself, we do connect the, we buy there from there and again from there itself we sell, right?
Yes. So I'm actually
do we connect both of them on Fiverr itself?
We can do from anywhere, it doesn't matter. See, you can do with Fiverr also. I used to do on Fiverr. I used to do on, there is another website site called SEO Clerks. I used to do on Warrior Forum. So there are a lot of places. See, there are different places where you can get the traffic.
Okay.
Here also you can get the traffic because see what happens is, let's take for example, a logo design. People search here for logo design.
Right.
Now, when they search here for logo design, now this is what comes. So one thing what actually now they have made it mandatory, earlier days actually not everybody one had a video. So what they have made it mandatory is because people with video were getting much better response. So I used to start actually doing everything on a video. So whatever service I have, I explain it on the video. So it could be through animation, it could be through anything else, or I can actually hire somebody like these people who are voiceover artists, they actually give with their video also. So they actually, you don't want yourselves to present, somebody else to present, you can actually just give them a script and they will actually do that for you. So that is also possible. Now, if you see here, these are all the different options. Now the objective is, we need to come in any of these plots. So for us to come in any of these plots, we do something called as search engine optimization. Now here there are other things like, for example, I have to come in this. I can actually, see, these are all the different filters which people will try to search for. So I need to ensure that I am available in most of these places. So in my description or in when I am actually listing out, I need to actually add all these things. More the service I am listing, I am actually available in more number of places. So people are going to see these things. People are going to search on various of these aspects. So based on this, they will actually select. So if I am available at, because a lot of people will have a limited budget, if I can actually get at a limited budget I am able to give, then it makes a lot of sense. So that's why I'm trying to tell you, you have to see from where you are going to buy and where you are going to sell. So you can buy from even freelancer. I'll talk to you about freelancer, what actually has to be done. But here in Fiverr, what you need to do is you need to go and list yourself. You can list yourself the same service which somebody else is actually offering. You can also actually do the same service. It doesn't matter. So what you will do is you will switch to selling and you will start actually creating the entire thing. You will actually create, let's say here, where is it? Okay, there is this gigs. What you need to do is you need to create a gig. As I said, create a gig is actually one of the thing, one of the product or service which you are trying to offer. So you need to actually put the details here. All these are self-explanatory. I will not get into adding these things, what actually has to be done. And it gives fantastic analytics, which will help you to decide what you need to do. I have actually exceeded the maximum number of gigs which I can have, because what happens is they are not allowing more than X number of gigs, because if I want more gigs, I need to remove any of them, then only I'll be able to do. So what happens is you need to just go and create an account and create a gig and start adding more and more details, because it will ask you a lot of details. Start adding all these details. Once you add all these details and once you have done, your gig will actually start appearing here on the on the dashboard. I have to again shift to buying. So I think I have Baskar sir, I have made you understand what actually you need to do. There are, it's not only in Fiverr, you can, you see, one thing is you need to buy from one person and you need to sell to somebody else. So selling to somebody else, for that you need to do a lot of work. Like what work is required is, first and foremost thing, we need to put the listing. So this is like a listing. Once you have put the listing, it is as good as actually it is your own website. Now let me show you. Now this guy, whoever has had this link, now this is his link. Now you can share this link to anybody. This particular page link, you can share with anyone. You can collect the payment here. What happens is the payment will first go to Fiverr, and Fiverr will actually release the payment to you. It takes some time because what happens is they want to actually ensure that there is no there is always a possibility that the client is not happy with your service. So they may actually say you need to alter this or you need to make some changes. Until unless they don't accept that order, or there is a time. See, they need to accept the order, or there is a time, I think around a week or so, they have actually given a buffer time. If they have not actually accepted the order also, then it will actually, Fiverr will consider it as accepted. And after that only they will actually release the payment. So for that reason, so payment first comes to Fiverr. But the beauty is you are building, don't think though you are paying a commission for them, it doesn't matter, because the advantage is you are building your reviews here, and that builds your credibility. And once this is done, you can share this with anybody. So people who are seeing online, they will see this. This is will be their online credibility, and which will help you to get more and more orders. So one of the thing is, first thing you need to do is list your service. You can list this in Fiverr, because in Freelancer you cannot list, you can only bid. I will talk about Freelancer, how it works a little later. First you understand how this works in Fiverr. I hope this is clear. In Fiverr what you need to do is you need to only list your service, product or service. And after that you need to share this. About traffic generation, I'll be taking separate sessions, because it is a there are so many methods in which you can develop traffic. So first is you need to identify what are you going to sell, what is that product or service which you want to sell, because based on that your entire strategy will happen. So based on that you will go to that places where people are actually going to be interested in your product or service. I hope Baskar sir, yes. Is this clear? Yes. Now?
Yeah, now
I may not be able to tell you everything in detail because of the lack of time. But
no.
The basic idea.
For information, for information, which is the best selling product as per your knowledge?
See, on Fiverr. On Fiverr, graphics and designs is one thing which sells a lot. Video animation sells a lot. Apart from that also, most of the things sells,
okay,
but
okay.
These two sell a lot on Fiverr. Anything in this?
Harsha, if I want to do a voiceover, so I would register in selling, right? Switch to selling.
Yes.
And again, okay. The same thing. I again have to get registered in the listing.
Yeah, you need to create the gigs. Once okay. You create the gig, you are listed. Now, then you need to promote that particular listing.
Okay. Got it. Yeah. Thank you.
Harsha Gopal here. One more question.
Yeah. Tell me, Gopal.
Is it user specific? I mean, let us say if I want to sell more than one service, let us say I want to sell SEO, or I want to sell logo making, I want to sell video making and animation. Now, how does, I mean, if I'm a single person, I'm selling multiple things.
Doesn't matter.
How do
you
I list?
Can do it.
I do that. Okay. And one more thing, is the listing premium like Google search? On what basis? That is, I want to appear on the top of the Fiverr search, for example, listing. Now, yeah. How does it really list? I may really go down the 500,000 in the listing, but nobody even look for. Even
so that's
though
why
I am good.
Saying, okay. See, let's take for example logo design itself. You start looking it from the buyer perspective. See, think from this. Number one thing, what actually clearly catches your attention is this, the thumbnail which is actually added here. This is called the thumbnail which you are seeing, the preview. Whatever,
but that is okay. How on what basis is this number 1, 2, 3 being displayed?
There are multiple things which are there. Number one, actually, it is based on the keyword which you are looking for. Number two, actually, the keyword has to be there in your description as well as on your the title. Number three, actually, it depends on how much reviews you have. Number four, it actually depends on the categories, whatever you have listed. You have to be in the right category. There are hundreds of things, but what actually happens is they keep shuffling this also. They will also put the new guy also on top here. Main thing is they are testing hundreds of things. Now see, this is an impression for them. Now out of this impression, if you are able to get a click out of this, and out of the click, whatever you are getting, if you are able to generate a revenue, because for them, what is very important is they get revenue. For them to get revenue, they need to actually get more and more sales with whatever they are listing here. So their entire strategy is based on optimizing this. So if you are getting a lot of sales, then they will promote you more. So it is very important for us to start promoting this. So one of the easiest thing what we personally do is we first promote this to our own personal group, where there is a higher probability that people will start actually buying something. Once they buy, there is some reviews which are there. That is where actually it will start picking up, because that is something which they see that this particular listing was less than 24 hours. It has started getting some orders. So they will want to actually go ahead and display it in multiple places. So we need to put in some effort in ensuring that we get more and more people looking for that. Another thing is, I was showing you here. See, look at this. When you are listing, it will ask you different things. So when you are available in more of these places, when you are able to give in multiple places, what happens is there is a higher probability that you are actually going to be shown to more people. So you will get more impressions based on that. It doesn't matter, even if you are in 500 position, still you will get impression. But impression is not important for Fiverr. Fiverr, the most important thing is you need to get sale. For them, conversion is important. If you are able to get them conversions, they will try to show you more. So there is Fiverr itself has a lot of thing like, if you go to the support, Fiverr has a support system. In the support system, they have let's go to Fiverr support. They have a community which is there. In the community, they have a lot of articles which are there which will help you. See, this is the community. So there's a forum, there is a blog, there are a lot of articles which is written by Fiverr, the top sellers of Fiverr. So you will get a lot of information there. That will be the best place for you to look for, because a lot of things they might be testing, they might have got success, they are sharing their success stories there. So they have done some experiment which actually has worked. So you have to go and keep looking, because something is working right now actually will really help you to grow this much further. I hope this answers your question, Gopal. Anybody else has any question before I quickly move on to freelancer, and then I think we are already 15 minutes up.
Just if you don't mind, one final question from my side.
Yeah, yeah, tell me, Gopal.
Is there any way wherein I get to see what people are trying to buy? Because let us say I think Bhaskar asked that question. Let us say I have no idea about what I want to sell. Now I go to Fiverr. I want to see what people are after buying. Let us say somebody is looking to buy a pickle, for example. Somebody wants to buy pickle or spices. I have absolutely no idea in my mind. But when I go there, I get an idea. Okay, this is a commodity people are looking for, and possibly this I can buy. So is there a possibility where I can get to know what people are looking for? That's my final question for Fiverr. Sorry to interrupt.
So I actually already answered this question, but let me tell you again. Graphic design and video and animation, these two are the hottest thing on Fiverr. What you can do is just go to any of these places. You go to any of them. Suppose this is logo animation. That is the place where you want to go. You go to that logo animation. Whatever is getting listed, it is getting listed because it is getting sales. Because as I told you, for them, impression is very important. More impression they are putting, they want you to actually get more sales. It doesn't matter, because what Fiverr makes money is only when you get paid. That is where they get paid. So whatever is getting listed here, that means these are selling.
Okay. Got you. Thanks.
One minute, Mr. Arsha, 1 minute.
Yeah.
See,
yeah.
You showed me list of people who are ready to sell their products. Can you show me where the list of people asking for the products?
No, they will not ask here. What happens? Fiverr, that doesn't work. In Freelancer, it works like that. In Fiverr, what happens is people, if they are interested, they will directly come and search for that and directly go ahead and buy. There is nothing else they will do. Freelancer works differently, like what you are asking, that works in Freelancer. It doesn't work in Fiverr. So what happens is, I have seen this person is doing good logo animation. I want something else to be done. I contact them personally and ask them. There's nothing else which you can do here. There is an option to contact seller. You personally speak to them and ask them. There's nothing else. And that is not actually, it's not... available for public display, so you will not be able to see that. That is only particular to that particular person. I hope this answers your question, Bhaskar. Hello?
Yeah.
So here you will not be able to see. I'll show you in the other place. Let's keep Fiverr aside right now. Let me show you how Freelancer works. Freelancer works completely different. Now, in Freelancer, what happens is you can actually hire at damn cheap rates. Even at starting from $2 an hour, you can actually start hiring people. And that's amazing thing, what you can do with Freelancer. Now, if you want to bid for projects, that is also possible. You can actually go ahead and look for what people are asking for. And then you will actually go ahead and bid the least possible thing. So what you could do is you can take orders here and go and outsource in Fiverr. That is also possible. So let me show you what actually is possible here. See, let's say I go browse for the project. I can just go ahead and browse for whatever projects I want, whatever projects are there. Now what happens here is, here individual people are going and listing themselves. They're saying that I want this particular service and this is my budget. Let me show you this. See, there are a lot of different kinds of projects which are coming up. Now, if you want to look at a specific projects, you can actually look for that specific projects. You can look, there are a lot of different options here. So there's something for content writing. There's you want to search for a specific project. For example, somebody is into web design. Let's take for example. You search for web design, you will get all web design related product. Suppose you want to do only data entry projects. You will get all this data entry related. Suppose you want to do logo design. Okay, logo, I think we have to search different terms and see graphics. Let me see. Okay, you can see a lot of people who have actually mentioned see what happens is it's here, it is not giving a proper result. So let's actually take one example here. Let's talk about the website design itself. Now I need a website. Now let's see this guy. He has put his requirements and he is also telling what is his budget. Now you can actually go ahead and bid for this. So this guy has a budget around 1.5 to 2.5 lakh. So now he has actually made certain things very, very clear that you can bid only if you have at least 5 reviews. If you are not having the reviews or if you are not having a professional membership, you are not allowed. So this is a way in which they restrict people from bidding, because here the entire thing works on bidding. It's like a tender. There's a tender which is actually put and you are trying to bid for that particular tender. So you can search for a lot of different products. You can search based on, see here, you can actually look for local jobs also. You can actually look for specific preferred freelancers you want to do. You can actually do for that. You want specific, you have your own freelancer, set of freelancers, you can also select them. Suppose only data entry related freelancers you want to do, you can actually select that.
Harsha, this creating account on Fiverr and freelancer is free, is it? Or you need to pay?
Yeah, everything is free. In freelancer, what happens is, bidding for a free guy per month, they give you some 15 or 20 bids free. So more than that, if you want to bid, you have to actually pay them. So they have different methodologies on which it works. It's still, you need to bid on a lot of projects before people start actually taking you seriously, and you need to get some reviews. See, everywhere people actually look at reviews. So you see a lot of different options are coming up here. So if you can get any orders here, you can actually go ahead and outsource this on Freelancer outsource this on Fiverr, or you can actually take a project here and outsource it here also. It doesn't really matter, because a person whom you are outsourcing, nobody knows. It's your talent ultimately. You are buying from one place, you are selling in another place. I am not able to hear you clearly. Can you be a little louder?
Yeah. Can you hear me now?
Yeah, but it's still not very clear. It's not very audible.
Can you hear me now?
It is better.
Okay. See, what I'm trying to say, let us say I'm selling animation and somebody likes my work also and he wants to buy it. Now, how does the transaction happen? Does it happen when I contact them? Because the payment will happen on Fiverr. So does the entire transaction happen in advance? Let's say, yes. I'm selling for, let us say, 2000 rupees.
Okay.
So he agrees to buy.
Correct.
So now he pays me 2000 rupees. Now when I want to service him, there'll be a lot of questions that I need to ask. I may have to get in touch with him. Now, does Fiverr or Freelancer allow us to get in touch with the seller and the buyer separately outside this platform?
In fact, they don't recommend, but we can find ways in which you can actually do that. Both of them have an option for you to chat with each other. You can directly chat with them directly there. So I would recommend you to do the chatting and all the things there itself, because what happens is if there is any dispute which actually occurs later, based on these details, whatever is available there, it can actually be much more easier to get it resolved. Because see, you might have promised X, the other guy might have actually thought something else. But when it is, everything is on crystal clear on paper, everything actually, because here in the chat, you can actually talk on the order page itself. You can actually talk. So there is all the options are available. So it will be only in terms of chatting, which is actually required. And to answer your, what was the other question? About your payment thing, understand one very important thing. When it comes to Fiverr, without a prayer payment, order is not actually processed at all. But in case of a freelancer, what happens is you need to ask them. See, when you are trying to bid and they award you a project, they actually are asked to here in case of freelancer, they have something called as milestone. We actually recommend you to take projects only if somebody is giving you a milestone, without a milestone, because when a milestone is placed, the money will be lying with freelancer. It will not be with you. It will not be with the guy who has actually given you the job. So it will be with the third party, which is freelancer. So as long as you have done your job and you have completed your obligations for reaching that milestone, you are entitled to get that payment. So what happens is, generally in a bigger projects, what they do is they divide that into multiple milestones. For example, I have a project which is for, say, 1 month. So I will give you a milestone every week. So after I complete 1 week work, I am supposed to get the payment. So the milestone payments are generally like that. And that can be, especially they have two options here. One is a fixed project. That is for the entire project, there is a cost. Maybe say $500, $1,000, whatever is the cost. That is one time fixed cost. The second option is about, it could be per hour basis. So per hour basis, you can clearly tell them that in a week, I need you to work for say 10 hours, 20 hours, 30 hours, 50 hours. It is up to you. You can set a limit for that. And for per hour, how much money you are ready to pay, you can set that also. So what happens is every week on Tuesday or Wednesday, they have a deadline. On that particular time, actually, it will automatically hit the account. So you have to attach your credit cards for this, and that will how it works. So you will know if somebody has actually issued a milestone. Only when they have put a milestone, then only accept the project. Otherwise, don't accept the project. Even if they have awarded the project, don't accept the project. Because first thing is, you have to bid here. Once you bid, they can actually give you the project. They may not give you the project, but when they give you the project, if there is milestone, then only you accept the project, because then it comes again to you. You have to accept or you can reject. It is up to you. So you can accept it only when you have a milestone. Milestone is there means the money is already there with freelancer. If it is with freelancer, you can get the payment. You don't have to worry. But if milestone is not there, and you have delivered the work, there is no way in which you can actually take the money from the other guy until unless the person is genuine and he wants to pay.
Okay, I get your point, but that would mean that the buyer will have to pay upfront, is it? Let us say I agree, he agrees to buy my services to making a website, which is actually 1 week. So does it mean that the buyer will pay only after the milestones, or the entire payment?
Yeah, on the milestones, you both have to decide on what is the milestone. See, you need to, for example, it could be 10% of the whole thing. For example, you have decided for say 10,000 rupees is your total project, and you want maybe for the first milestone, you are paying only maybe 1,000 rupees or something. So you both actually decide and actually agree upon certain things, and you can put a milestone. It is like a token payment which you are giving. It's more of that.
Got it. Thanks.
Sorry, again, I'm not able to clearly hear you.
No, I said thanks for the clarification. I got my answer. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Is there any other question? I think otherwise, I think today I'm done for today. I think I've given you all the details which are required for you to get started. See, again, here, either to do a freelancing or to get there is a lot of work which has to be done. You need to build portfolios. You need to do a lot of things. And if you do it effectively, even if you are personally not doing, you can still be a middleman and you can still make a lot of money in this. As I said, you can actually buy and sell both on Freelancer. You can buy and sell on Fiverr, or you can buy in Fiverr, sell in Freelancer. You can take in actually Freelancer and you can actually sell in Upwork. So there are hundreds of ways in which you can do it. It's all up to you about you knowing where you have to buy and where you need to sell.
Okay. Harsha, will you be sharing these videos? Because yesterday also we did. I don't know if I have missed that video.
No, I have not shared yet. I will share this.
Okay.
Is there anybody else having any other questions? If there is no other question, I think I will wind up for today. I think I am done for today's main topic. I would request all of you, if you find that I have given value for whatever I have done for this today, yesterday, I just need a video testimonial which will really help me in selling my other courses. So I have been, this is mainly the request which I can make here. I am more interested in that. So if you can just give a video testimonial, because whatever I'm doing, I'm actually mainly trying to help you out in whatever best I can do. So if there is anything else I can do, you can please tell me. Okay. Pramod is asking, what are the best paid plans on both these sites? Freelancer has a paid plan. You can start with the basic plan and then you can upgrade it. See, what happens, it's all about the bids. It starts actually giving you more and more bids. So you can start with free also, start seeing, and then you can always upgrade. In Fiverr, there is no paid plan at all. In Fiverr, it is only based on the commission. So only when you get orders, they cut the commission and then they pay you. So that's a simple thing which they do.
How do you know how much commission they take?
See, commission, everything is actually mentioned there. Earlier, they used to take a lot. I have paid 20% commissions earlier. For every order, I had to pay 20%.
So when we register for something, I think while registering upfront, it will say, right? There's so much of commission, is it?
It is actually there in their contract. You can actually see now, actually they have reduced. I think it is hardly some 5% commission or something. So it's pretty less compared to earlier days. Now the volumes are very high. Earlier, what used to happen is we were actually having only this $5 thing, which was there. Then it used to be there. I can actually upsell maximal for some $100 or something. So now actually even the beginner can actually start doing for more than that. Easily around $500 ticket size you can actually do with Fiverr, which is amazing. Okay, Rohit is asking, is it required to invest money in digital marketing? Rohit, for your personal business, you have to definitely invest money to, if you want to do on your own, then no need. But if you have to outsource it, yeah, then yes, there is money which is required.
Harsha, yesterday I think you left your coordinates to contact, and by the end of it, I unfortunately got accept. So are you going to share your?
Okay, I'll just share it again. No issues. I'm just sharing you my contact details. So whoever wants to get in touch with me, you can get in touch with me.
I don't see your chat.
Sorry. One second. It went to a private chat.
Okay.
Okay, Rohit is asking, is there any ways to lose investment? Rohit, if you are talking about the Freelancer or a Fiverr, you know what is the service you are paying, what exactly you are paying for. So I don't see any reason why you have to lose any investment. And for example, you are doing this in Freelancer. And the guy who was supposed to do is actually, they have agreed on some milestones for which you are supposed to pay. You will pay only when they have completed the milestone, because after they have completed the milestone, they are going to request for payment, and that is where you will, only when you are satisfied, you will release the payment. The payment will still be with freelancer. It will not be there with it will be there with the freelancer account, which I'm talking about. I'm talking about the company. It will not be with the guy who has actually done the work. So only when you release the payment, then only the guy will get the amount. Otherwise, he will not get.
How do we submit? Let us say if the logo is done, I hope that I will submit it to the freelancer or the Fiverr. It is directly not go to the end user, right?
They have an order page itself. There itself, they have an option for you to submit. So even for freelancer, they have all the files to be uploaded there itself. So everything you do it there itself. So you have very clear understanding, even as a third party. See, freelancer or Fiverr, they are your third party. So they have given you all the tools. You need to utilize their tools, because when you have done that, then they know exactly that you have delivered whatever you have promised for. Okay. When you have delivered whatever you have promised for, then that actually takes care of everything.
Okay, I think too many questions from my side. Thank you so much.
No problem.
Your coordinates you have shared, and you have shared your phone number also. Thank you so much for that. What is your preferred mode? I mean, do you prefer to be pinged on chat first?
Anything is fine. You can see if you are calling. I'm not able to pick the call. I may call you back later.
Okay, fine. Okay, I'll call you back. I have also written to you on the same email ID yesterday. I don't know if you have really got that email. Yesterday evening, I have written to you.
Okay, I will check. And I will reply back.
I will contact you over the phone. Thanks. Okay. Thank you so much. Okay.
Thank you very much. Is there any other question anybody else has, or else I will end the meeting?
Good to go. Thank you so much, Harsha.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. I think it's good to go. Nobody else has any other question. Thank you.
Thank you so much. And thanks for all your effort, Harsha. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Yeah. Bye.